This is Mission Control Houston. It has been an incredibly busy and whirlwind week for the crew of Expedition 34 on board the International Space Station. Their week got kicked off on Monday with quite a bit of cargo unloading from the SpaceX Dragon spacecraft that is currently docked with the International Space Station. The crew made quick work of getting all of this cargo and the supplies and scientific experiments that came up on Dragon unloaded within about 24 hours or so after Dragon first arrived. There was 1,268 pounds of equipment that came up. They got all that moved out. They're in the process now of moving back over 2,668 pounds of equipment and supplies and scientific experiments that will come home at the end of March, on March 25th, as Dragon makes a splashdown off the coast of Baja California. Dragon also brought up two grapple bars that were removed in the middle of the week from its external payload trunk. This is an unpressurized section of Dragon that brought up these two pieces of equipment. The ground teams commanded the station's 58-foot-long robotic arm to reach in and retrieve these two grapple bars. They are currently stowed out on a payload attachment point that is part of the station's mobile base structure. That is where they will stay until this summer when Chris Cassidy and Luca Parmitano, as part of Expedition 35, will go outside and conduct a couple of spacewalks. This first one will be focused on a variety of things, including moving those grapple bars from that temporary spot over to the S1 and P1 truss. These two grapple bars would be used in the event that one of the station's radiators needed to be replaced. Dragon also took up an experiment called the coarsening and solid liquid mixtures experiment. This takes a look at how liquid metal solidifies and coarsens up in space. There's lessons to be learned in terms of how zero gravity affects that particular process. But this CSLM experiment has been running inside the microgravity sciences glove box over the next several days. There's going to be 21 days worth of operations of this particular experiment, and then it will come back home with Dragon at the conclusion of the mission. Robonaut also being put through its paces earlier this week. Yesterday, on Thursday, the particular robot on board the space station was moved through a series of arm movements. Also, its vision sensor was checked out. As ground teams watched on, Robonaut checked out A-OK. Also, Thursday and Friday were spent doing some work on the carbon dioxide removal assembly unit inside the Kibo laboratory. This particular CEDRA is typically housed inside the Tranquility node, but Tom Marshburn and Kevin Ford spent a lot of time, almost two full days, working on this particular piece of equipment that is part of the station's environmental system. It scrubs out carbon dioxide from the air, makes it acceptable for the crew to use. They had to swap out some of the beds that help scrub that air, and also a valve, but you get a sense of exactly how big this piece of equipment is. That is why they moved it into Kibo, so they could work on it a little bit easier. And then over the weekend, the crew should be moving it back over to Tranquility and reactivating it once again. In the meantime, Kevin Ford, Oleg Novitsky, and Evgeny Tarelkin now in their final days aboard the International Space Station as part of Expedition 34. This trio getting ready to wrap up 143 days in space, 141 days aboard the International Space Station. We'll have live coverage coming up on March 14th as they depart the International Space Station and head home. Our first broadcast will begin at 3:45 p.m. Central Time. We'll have live coverage of the farewells and the hatch closure, which actually should take place at around 4:15 p.m. Central Time, 5:15 p.m. Eastern Time. Our second broadcast will come on the air at 7:15 p.m. Central. We'll have live coverage of the undocking of the Soyuz TMA-06M with Ford, Novitsky, and Tarelkin inside. That undocking should take place at 7:30 p.m. Central Time as they back away from the Poisk module. Our third and final broadcast will air at 9:45 p.m. Central Time with landing coverage. The deorbit burn will occur at 10:04 p.m. Central Time. That'll begin the process of sending Ford, Novitsky, and Tarelkin back through Earth's atmosphere, and they will land less than an hour later at 10:57 p.m. Central Time. They're going to be landing just to the northeast of the town of Arkalyk. That is the northern landing zone there in Kazakhstan. The weather due to be in the 20s, climbing up to the 30s throughout the day, but it will be 9:57 a.m. the next morning, March 15th, there at the landing site. Of course, we will have live coverage not only on NASA television, but also on www.nasa.gov ISS.mil/station.